So I don't want to be too arrogant. I don't want folks to become complacent, but I will say this. I think that as it stands right now, Senator Nina Turner is in a very good position to win the race that she's running in Ohio's 11th congressional district. And you can really gauge how well she's doing based on the level of desperation that we're seeing from her opponents. And it's almost embarrassing. Like, you feel sad for her opponents. One in particular who's practically begging and pleading with super PACs to help fund her campaign against Nina Turner. And the types of super PACs that she's really targeting here and asking for the support of, they come from the Israel lobby. And it's really just, this is craven, honestly. So for more on this, we go to Ryan Grimm of The Intercept, who explains Chantel Brown's campaign for Congress is blaring one of the least subtle messages sent to a super PAC since the outside money groups were legalized by the Supreme Court in its Citizens United v. FEC decision. Brown's campaign has listed on its website a set of negative talking points about her opponent, Nina Turner, all enclosed in a bright red box. Directly under the red box is a quote from Democratic consultant Mark Melman, the leader of a major pro-Israel super PAC that has consistently spent large sums of money against Senators Bernie Sanders and his congressional allies. Red box is a campaign industry term referring to the spot on the website that candidates use to communicate with outside groups like super PACs. The communication on Brown's website is a textbook case of red box signaling used to communicate with outside groups within the letter of the law. To understand how the signaling works, it's useful to review the conventions of post-Citizens United campaign practices. Per the Citizens ruling, campaigns cannot coordinate with outside groups, and doing so is a clear violation of one of the few bright line rules in campaign finance. The challenge then for a campaign is figuring out how to guide a super PAC or outside supporters' messaging without running afoul of the laws around coordination. For that, campaigns have developed what is called the red box. The candidate posts opposition research or videos on their website about their opponent, which anyone in the public is then free to use for any purpose. The oppo also generally includes messages about both candidates that have tested well in polls, allowing the super PAC to align its communications with the campaigns. What makes Brown's approach unique is both how blatant it is and how beseechingly it directs itself to a particular head of a particular super PAC. First, the oppo research Brown's campaign posted is literally inside an actual red box, removing any confusion as to the purpose of the exercise. If any confusion still existed, the link PDF is called SB4C Red Box. Now, to actually see what Ryan Grimm is talking about here in this article, let's go to Chantel Brown's website. Now, as you can see, there is this giant red box, and within said red box are all of the talking points that she is giving to super PACs. They're negative talking points against Nina Turner and talking points for herself. Ideally, I think she wants these talking points to be included in an ad that the super PAC runs on her behalf. Now, additionally, if you scroll up, there's some quotes here that really stand out because these are the only quotes here. Quote, "There's no question that Brown is going to be a strong advocate for the U.S.-Israel relationship. This is by DMFI PAC President Mark Melman. She wants to learn. She is inquisitive, and she has a track record of being collaborative." Mike Siegel of the Jewish Agency. "We need leaders in Congress who value the U.S.-Israel relationship and will work to strengthen security, economic, scientific, and cultural relationships between our two nations. And that candidate in the 11th district race is Chantel Brown," by Jeff Mendelsohn of Pro-Israel America. In other words, please, 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 pretty please, Israel lobby, fund my campaign more. I really need your help. I have your back. Please have mine. This is what all of the leaders in the Israeli lobbying industry are saying about me. So please, come to my rescue. Now, if you're wondering, why would a candidate in the 11th Congressional District of Ohio care so much about this one issue in particular, care so much about Israel? I mean, there's a bunch of industries that could theoretically bankroll her campaign. I mean, the healthcare industry, the pharmaceutical industry. But why in particular is she focusing on the Israel lobby? Well, there's a very specific reason for that. Ryan Grimm continues. "The hybrid super PAC run by Melman, Democratic Majority for Israel, spent heavily against Sanders during the presidential primary, dropping $1.4 million in its effort to slow him in Iowa and beyond. The super PAC also spent more than $1.5 million attacking Jamal Bowman and supporting then-incumbent New York Representative Elliot Engel. Despite their efforts, Bowman won. It also threw in $179,000 against Alex Morris, who challenged House Ways and Means Chair Richie Neal in a Western Massachusetts primary. DMFI was also bankrolled in 2020 by a super PAC that tried to unseat Representative Ilhan Omar in her Minnesota Democratic primary. Americans for Tomorrow's Future, which spent more than $3 million taking on Omar and also worked against Bowman, sent $500,000 to DMFI. There is overlap among donors as well. A top donor to AFTF, who contributed $300,000 in 2020, also gave $1.245 million to DMFI. So in other words, she knows that these groups usually fund candidates who are running against progressives. And so she's hoping that they will listen to her and realize the situation and that Nina Turner is doing really well and help give her a little bit of a bump. It's honestly embarrassing. It's pathetic. Imagine having so little grassroots support that you practically have to beg super PACs to run smear campaigns against your opponent. It's disgusting. It's grotesque. And, you know, I wonder if she is going to get any questions within her district about her begging for support from the Israel lobby as Israel is trying to expel Palestinians out of their homes in the East Jerusalem city of Sheikh Jarrah. I wonder if there's going to be any questions for her. It seems like she's more concerned about what's happening in Israel than what's happening in her district. And I mean, look, this is what desperation looks like. And I think that we all know what we have to do now. Since she is putting out the signal to super PACs to help bankroll her campaign and smear Nina Turner, we have to help Nina Turner. So go to ninaturner.com and donate to Nina Turner. You can also buy merch. I purchased the sweater. It's great. All of the donations that we're giving to Nina Turner right now, I consider it a sort of investment because Nina Turner, she's not going to fight for any lobby. She's going to actually represent the people, not just in her district, but in America, broadly speaking. And Chantel Brown, she's trying to find reasons to attack Nina Turner, but Nina Turner is running a very substantive campaign. So the best she can come up with is that Nina Turner isn't adequately loyal to the Democratic Party. Okay, so are we running on loyalty or are we running on actual policies? I think it's clear where Nina Turner stands. She supports policies that the people in the 11th Congressional District of Ohio need and want. So we have to have Nina Turner's back because I guarantee that the super PACs are going to see the bat signal that Chantel Brown is putting out and they're going to listen. They're going to support her as they did support other corporate Democrats against progressives. So we have to make sure that whenever we see this happen, we ramp up the effort, not just when it comes to donations, but if you can, get on the ground and do some grassroots campaigning, activism, phone banking, door knocking, if you can, for Nina Turner, because that is what is needed currently to make sure that Nina Turner is electorally successful. It's not a foregone conclusion that she's going to win. She's doing very well, but as she does better, as her polling numbers increase, as she gains more support, that's when it's going to get more difficult for us and when we really have to show our support for Nina Turner, because that's when the attacks and the money is going to roll in to try to stop her momentum. So we'll try to stop that as much as we can and support Nina Turner.